Hey, good optometry morning. Before you order your progressives, there are six things that you need to know. Hey, Dr. Michael Nelson here, YouTube Eye Doctor, and today with me is Peter Wessels, and he's the key account manager and the Nikon field trainer for Nikon Lenswear Canada. And he's here to talk to us about progressive lenses. Welcome. So first of all, a progressive is this super high-tech lens that allows you to do a little bit of everything. We need this lens when we start to lose our autofocus ability, and you need something to help you see far away and up close. So basically, in a nutshell, a progressive, the top part of the lens lets you see things far away, like driving and watching TV. And then as you look down, the power changes and you get a sweet spot so you can see things up close, reading your phone, reading books. There's an area where you can see computer. And that's what a progressive lens is. All right, so Peter, I have a lot of patients that come in and they tell me and say, I've tried a progressive lens and this just doesn't work for me.
Sure. Well, there's a bunch of different types of progressive lenses that we get nowadays. The biggest challenge is getting used to the lens design itself. So inferior lens designs are asking us to do the opposite of what we've been doing our whole life with head and eye movements. And that's the biggest challenge.
What I often find with my patients is that I tell them it's not that you have to get used to it, but you more have to learn how to use it. Another thing that patients will often say, I've been shopping around, I've been looking for different progressives. One place is they're like $250, and there's the other place they're like $1,000. Like a progressive is a progressive. What's the difference in the price points?
Well, there's a lot of differences, but the easiest way to think about it is on a $250 lens price point on a progressive lens, oftentimes you have one lens design. So they have one lens design to fit every single type of prescription that is out there. So it's almost like a one size fits all approach, which is okay for about 20% of prescription, but about 80% of them are going to have a bad experience. Whereas with $1,000 ones, for every single prescription, it's fully customized to make sure that it fits your specific needs.
So one of the things that I often tell my patients, kind of like cars, you know, there's different car dealers, there's like Audi, Ford, Chevrolet, and then each car company has different models in it. Nikon has a portfolio of products. You've got a, you know, some of your premium top-end lenses, but you've got some entry-level lenses as well. How many lens designs does Nikon have?
Within the progressive lens portfolio, we've got about six different options. The other one I like to use is TVs. If you go to Best Buy, you can see all the TVs lined up good to great, and the picture quality changes all the way through. And that's one thing that, you know, you also get on a better lens design is a better picture quality. That means sharper, crisper, and clearer vision.
And with progressive lenses, I talked about they have kind of a sweet spot when you're looking up close, and all of them, I say they have a little bit of wonkiness off to the side, and all progressives have some of that, but the better quality ones have better optics, so you've got a bigger sweet spot, so you get less of that wonkiness, they're easier to learn how to use. Okay, so we talked a little bit about there's lots of different types of progressives, so I imagine it's more than just like checking a box, okay, I want this premium one. There's a bunch of different measurements that you need to get this fit for you specifically.
So for us to be able to manufacture a lens specifically to your needs, we need to know exactly how that frame is fitting on your face. And we also need to know exactly where your eye is positioned in that frame. So we want to know how far your eyes are apart from each other when you're looking far. We want to know how far your eyes are apart from each other when you're looking at something reading, because our eyes converge when we read. And also we want to know how high those eyes are within the frame itself. And that way, those are just some of the measurements that we can start to use to customize the lens itself. On top of that, we also want to know how the frame actually fits onto your face, because the frame fitting on your face is also going to make a big difference on how we manufacture that lens. We want to know how far the lens is away from your eye. We want to know all the different angles of the frame itself. And all of that is going to allow us to customize that lens to your specific needs to be able to offer the widest possible fields of view and the sharpest and crispest and clearest vision.
So I'm counting like six or seven specific measurements that you need on a patient, like how at the angle of the lens, the wrap of the lens, how far that lens is from your eye on that specific frame. So premium progressive lenses, they're really highly custom. Nikon also has a really unique thing that they have, a sensitivity test.
What the sensitivity test does is it allows us to determine how sensitive a patient is to distortion itself. And in that way, we can push off that distortion off to the sides. So to the patient, it seems like there's just about no distortion at all.
All right, so when you get all this information, what does Nikon do with that?
We take all of that and we send that to our supercomputer in Japan. and it's called our Nikon Optical Design Engine. Put all that information into the software there, and then it tells us how to manufacture that lens.
Now, sometimes the prescriptions can be so complicated that that can take a few hours for it to do that calculation to find that design. Is that correct?
Absolutely, yeah. It keeps on going through and going through until it optimizes the lens to the best possible result that we can maximize those visual zones and be able to offer that patient the sharpest, crispest, and clearest vision based on all of those different measures.
All right, so another thing that sometimes happens is I get a patient, because not every optical or optometry clinic carries every brand of lens. Well, now, I'll preface that because a lot of independent optometrists, they do have access to almost every company and every lens design. And so sometimes you'll go, here's a Nikon lens that you can get here, and then, oh, I'll shop around or go someplace else. And they say, well, we don't carry Nikon, but we have this one. It's just as good. So how does a consumer that's looking at comparing apples to apples, how do they do that with progressive lenses?
Well, Michael, anytime I hear someone say to me, just as good, it's a red flag that it's probably inferior. Unless it's supported by the brand or supported by the technology, I'd say you're probably not going to be able to get an apples to apples comparison on that.
And important for people to know, because you know it's tricky. You're buying an invisible product. You can't see and touch it until it's done. So you have to, you know, rely and be comfortable and trust your doctor or your optician that you're dealing with, that they're giving you a quality product. All right, so Peter, if there's one thing that you could share that for people that are considering purchasing either their first or second or third pair of progressive lenses?
Well, if we take a look at, you know, one of your questions in the beginning, the difference between a $250 lens and a $1,000 lens, that's going to be the difference between an average or below average performing lens and the best possible vision you can get. And if you use that analogy of $250 to $1,000, it boils down to a dollar a day for the best possible vision you can have.
And that's a good point. And I think sometimes people forget. You think, what else do you wear every single day? I don't even wear the same watch every single day, other than maybe my wedding ring. There's nothing else that I wear every single day. And so that worth the investment in your vision.
Absolutely. And it can alter your entire quality of life. You might have to give up hobbies because your vision is not so good. None of that is true if you have a fantastic lens.
All right, so when you're looking at progressives, make sure you know that there's many different options for you to consider, and look at those different options and try to give you the best experience with your progressives. And if you want to learn some of my progressive buying tips, then you can watch this video right here. And with that, have a great optometry day.